All the News Hour debate tonight. Dr. Rita Bahuguna Joshi was supposed to come on the News Hour Congress spokesperson. She's pulled out at the last minute. I'm placing that on record. She was about to come, but for some reason, she's not able to join us, perhaps. In any case, we have a BJP representative, Satyapal Jain, national head of the BJP's legal cell. Shailesh Gandhi, the original RTI activist of India, former CIC. Thank you very much, Shailesh Gandhi. And TSR Subramaniam, the most outspoken bureaucrat I have known. TSR Subramaniam, you know, is there an all-party coalition for this now, secret alliance to somehow make the amendment?
Yes, Arnab, I thought if the amendment actually takes place tomorrow or in the near future,
yeah.
I think it will be an extremely sad day for our democracy. I think in the last 9 years, this has been the only real achievement of the UPA, at least in my view, to bring to some extent the RTI transparency to the system. And even that single achievement is being torpedoed. Now, are the interests of 1,000, 2,000 MPs and MLAs to override the wishes of 130 crore people? Do the MPs represent the views of our, are they sultans managing the country? Don't we have, isn't this a clear signal that we don't want electoral reforms? We are very happy with 20, 30 crores per election against the 30, 40 lakh limit. What every party is funded by the public one way or the other, and every party controls governments, parliament, policies. It impinges on the life of every citizen. And how can they argue under what kind of, suppose in America, when 95% of the people want the change, the senators or reps refuse to have their own way, or in UK,
yeah,
will they stay in office for more than 10 days? I think we have to review this very serious development for the country. If this happens, my conclusion will be, we are not going to be a democracy. Okay, call it whatever you want, it is not a democracy anymore.
Gopinath Munde of the BJP, Satyapal Jainji, Gopinath Munde of the BJP has declared spending 19 lakh
yes
in his election, declared, right? But in a speech or in a comment, he says that he spent 8 crore in his 2009 Lok Sabha election. So the question really is, we want to know how these parties operate, you see. We want to know where the money comes from. Are you for or against this amendment?
See, I have to make two submissions. I will like to make the position of the BJP very clear. BJP never demanded this type of amendment in the RTI Act. So far as we are concerned, we are in favor of public transparency in public life. We submit our accounts, our estimate, our expenditure, income, etc. every year as required by law to the Election Commission of India. We are in favor of proper transparency in public life. And so far as the applicability of the RTI Act to political parties is concerned, we have already said that let certain parameters be laid down. We are not against making this act applicable to political parties.
I want
parties
to know.
But the
I want to know where your money comes from. No, I'm very specific.
One second.
First of all, Mr. Satyapal Jain, I think that you are only giving us a formal legal line. You're not speaking from the heart tonight on the News. If you really meant it, then you, Mr. Satyapal Jain, can go to court. You can challenge the CIC order in court, but you can challenge anything the government does in court today, but you're not doing that. You are only officially saying that I'm against it. You are not clear on where you stand. I don't think you're taking a clear position. I'm asking you again for a second time. If the government tries to push the RTI amendment through, will you fight it on the floor of parliament?
That is what he has said.
Has he said so?
He said that BJP never wanted amendment.
No,
this is what his statement is.
And you have, as a matter of fact, supported what I'm saying. If we were against CIC order, we could have gone to the court of law to challenge. We never challenged that order.
Fair
it was the CIC order which said that RTI is applicable to political parties.
Yes.
BJP never challenged that order. Now, so far as the amendment part is concerned, let the first amendment come.
You've not complied with the order either.
Is doing.
And you, you have not complied with the order either. Only the Communist Party of India has complied with the order.
So it is for the Congress and the Cabinet to first come out clarity as to what is the amendment that they are bringing.
Mr. Jain, do I understand correctly, if I may, that you are saying at this moment BJP is not in favor of amendments? Because that would be a great thing. Citizens, all of us will applaud you, Mr. Jain.
Absolutely.
I think that's the statement you are making. Do I understand
BJP
you correctly?
BJP is in favor of public transparency in public life. Number
right.
two.
No, no.
Number two, no, we are not against making, we are not against making RTI applicable to political parties. What we are saying is, lay down certain parameters, lay down certain criteria relating to political or non-political organization, trust and everybody. And any institution, maybe political or non-political, if it fits in that, RTI should be applicable to them.
Mr. Jain, same form of the government. Yeah, go ahead.
The law has defined it already. Look, the parliament makes law. Once the law is made, everybody in the country has to follow it. Those who do not follow the law are criminals and have no intention of following the rule of law. Members of parliament cannot do that, which is what unfortunately has been done. But even now, I would welcome your statement if you said, we do not want to amend the act because that would be incorrect. It's immoral to
He's
amend
the
law.
He's not saying that. That's the point. He is not saying that. Mr. Satyapal Jain, which side are you on? You see, this is the problem with the BJP. You have to decide whether you're opposing the government attempts to amend the RTI or you are with the government. You can't say on the news, I am neither here nor there, let the government do what it does. No, because Mr. Jain, your actions.
Move an amendment in the act. Let us first be clear. What is the amendment that the Congress is bringing? Only then we can react.
Mr. Satyapal Jain, you can be accused that every time the CIC asked you, your party, for transparency. You talk about transparency tonight, Mr. Jain. In November 2012, Shailesh Gandhi will bear me out on this. I think the CIC asked six parties. NCP, Congress, BJP, BSP, CPM and one more party. I don't know which the fifth one was. Share details such as the land leased out to you and the rent paid for it. Tell me, Mr. Gandhi, did the BJP even reply to that?
Unfortunately not.
It didn't even bother replying.
Yet I am saying are political parties who want to make a difference and say we want to go with the citizens, I would certainly welcome it instead of saying
what it reflects is the bigger story, Mr. Subramaniam, that political parties in the first place are not keen on being answerable for their finances.
As far as the earlier party is concerned,
no, political parties
I'm not
don't
aware
want
of that notice, but one thing is very clear. After the CIC order came,
the BJP
never challenged that order. We never went to any court of law challenging the validity of that order.
No. The question is transparency of your finances.
As a matter of fact, Mr. Arun Jaitley wrote an article saying that apply all these parameters to all the parties.
Yes, sir, Subramaniam. No, you go ahead, Mr. Subramaniam.
Arnab, I am happy to hear one clear statement that we are not against this interpretation by this. It's extremely welcome. First time I'm hearing in the last 2 months, number one. Number two, what the CIC has ruled is now the law of the land. It is not for us to discuss it. The only place which we can discuss is in the court of law. We can only go to High Court, Supreme Court and appeal against it. Now the first two, three questions arise. If the law of the land, there is now continuing contempt of the law today. Parties are not have not established their offices, etc., number one. Number two, those who believe in the law of the land should take steps. Number three, I have repeatedly heard the BJP, I am happy to hear this, that he who pays the piper calls the tune. Every rupee of income, every rupee of expenditure, at least the first step we should reduce corruption in that area. Let them unilaterally start an office in their party, announce everywhere, to this extent, we are from tomorrow meeting the requirement of the CIC Act, and then say that we have certain reservations
about
which we will appeal,
not.
Amend the law, etc. On this, we agree. Let them come out.
No, this
please
is the same position.
The same
this
kind
is
of a game that we played in the case of Lokpal.
Exactly. Huge, this is the game played in the case of Lokpal.
And a lot of games being played.
This is the game played in the case of the Lokpal, even at that point of time by the BJP. Let the Congress decide.
Exactly.
Let the government decide what they want to do with the Lokpal. I'm asking you to have, which is why I began the debate by saying the Congress spokesperson was supposed to come on the news hour but dropped out at the last minute. I'm placing that on record. I would have asked a few tough questions to the Congress spokesperson had they come. But my question goes back to the BJP, since the BJP is on the program. I want to know whether the BJP is committing on national television that you will not allow such an amendment.